Hello friends, welcome to our video where we are discussing the CSIR NET GRF life sciences questions from yesteryears. So here the first question is from the chemical bonding part, and it says that which of the following bases has the largest hydrogen bonding possibility. Now you must understand the question will be logic based, and it will be covering both the chemical bonding and the kind of biomolecules that you have studied. So here they are considering the biomolecule which is the nucleotide base. Here you have four nucleotides: adenine, guanine, cytosine and uracil. So let's go to their structure and find out why guanine has the largest hydrogen bonding possibility. It is because out of all these bases, the guanine has maximum number of electron donating sites. Now you all know that any molecule which has largest number of electron donating sites or are electronegative, more electronegative, can form more bonds. So here guanine forms a triple bond with cytosine because it has three sites from which it can form hydrogen bond. Now guanine not only forms a triple bond with cytosine, but it can also form bond between itself and make the structure that is G3 or G4. That means 3 guanine or 4 guanine. Those are called the quadruplexes, G quadruplexes, which are also the part of DNA molecule. So you know that it is because of the electron donating sites of the guanine, it forms larger number of bonds or hydrogen bonds. So let's go to the next question. Here it says glucose residues in amylose are linked by which of the given linkages. It is very important for you to understand that there are two kinds of linkages. One is linear and another is for branched. So amylose has a linear chain. So any molecule which has a linear chain and having glucose residues will form alpha 1,4 linkage. Why is it alpha? Because both of the OH of the first glucose and the second glucose molecule, the first carbon and the fourth carbon of the second glucose molecule will form bond, and the OH at first carbon and OH at fourth carbon are on the above plane. That means they are above the plane, and that is why they are forming alpha. If they are on the opposite planes, that is one OH is above the plane and another OH is below the plane, then it will form beta 1,4 linkage. But here in the linear chain of amylose, it forms alpha 1,4 linkage. If you see the similar kind of molecule, that is amylopectin, it also forms alpha 1,6 along with alpha 1,4 because it has a branching. Amylopectin has branch, and that is why it forms alpha 1,6, where the first carbon of a glucose molecule forms bond with the sixth carbon of the another glucose molecule, and hence the chain is formed. So now you know that amylose has alpha 1,4, but amylopectin has both alpha 1,4 and alpha 1,6 linkage. This question, the COH group of cellular amino acid can form which of the following bonds inside the cell? Now these are the options: ether and ester, ester and amide, amide and ether, or amide and carboxylic anhydride. So now the explanation is the kind of bonding or kind of molecule that amino acid can form with another molecules. So here if you see, it can form an ester bond and it can also form an amide bond. Amide bond is the peptide bond that is present between the amino acids, and it can also form ester bond because it has COOH ring. Now let's go to the next question. Which of the following statements is correct? And this question has been taken from December 2015. It says that all L amino acids, only the C alpha carbon is chiral. So it is not so, because there are some molecules like lysine which has no other chiral carbons. Then you have deoxyribose is optically inactive. This is also a wrong option. Then the specific rotation of sucrose and will be the sum of specific rotation of D glucose and D fructose. No, it is not so. It depends on the kind of specific rotation of the glucose and fructose given in the solution. Then phosphatidylcholine is isolated from biological membrane, is optically active. Now why is it saying from biological membrane? Because biological membrane have phospholipid, and phospholipid have the chiral carbons which are present on the glycerol backbone. So you know that glycerol is present in the phospholipid, and those phospholipids are phosphatidylcholine, and they have chiral center, hence they are optically active. So you have to understand everything, that why each of these words are given. For example, the biological membrane, why is it not given that only phosphatidylcholine is active? Because it has been isolated from membrane which have phospholipids. Because the cell membrane is made up of phospholipid bilayer, and this phosphatidylcholine chirality or its optically activeness can be found out from the circular dichroism signals. Thank you so much for visiting our site, and hope this video is helpful to you. Thank you.